Hi, I am Uncle Awesome and I spend thousands of dollars on old computers. But why? When I first get them, they might not even work. I have to repair them, look forever for drivers, buy replacement parts. I have to spend hours and days trying to make them work, and it can be very, very frustrating. And when it finally works, I play some games. Games that compared to modern games looks terrible, sounds terrible. And then I buy another computer. Or if I'm lucky, I can find one in a dumpster. Because for most people, that's where they belong. But not for me, and many others. So why do I do this? Well, let me try to explain why. The first and most obvious answer is the feeling of nostalgia. And yes, you can use emulators to play many, if not every old game you can find. But you don't just remember the game. You remember the machine, the floppy disks, the sounds, the anticipation as the game is loading in. And to have the real computer, the same computer you had back in the day, makes the past so much more real, and you get closer to the wonderful feeling of nostalgia. The Commodore 64 was my very first computer, and now I'm playing Paperboy on the Commodore 64 exactly like I did when I was a kid. But I don't feel any nostalgia. Nostalgia is something that comes every now and then. For example, when you suddenly remember a game that you had forgotten about. But for 99% of the time, I don't feel any nostalgia. So what else keeps me going? There is something else about old computers. I played on the Amiga 500 and 1200, but I never saw the Amiga 2000. I don't think I even ever knew about it. So the Amiga 2000 is not nostalgic to me, but I still love this beast. Look at how big the motherboard is. All those different expansion slots. Makes me curious. What can I install here? And the expansion cards are so huge. And you can see all of the electronic components. This card here is very interesting. It's a PC on a card. So you can have a DOS PC inside the Amiga. All computers are just interesting, and I'm curious about them. And just to know that this computer is from 1988 is just awesome to me. So this is Quake 2 from 1997. And I really wanted to play this game. But my PC was just way too slow. And I could not enjoy this game. I remember I was so envious of my friends and other family members that got faster and faster machines. Like my nephew got a 300 MHz, my friend got a 400 MHz, then my brother got a 700 MHz, and I was stuck with a Pentium 100 MHz, and I could not play the cool games that they could play. But today, I can take revenge of my past. I can pretend it's 1997, and build the most powerful computer that was possible to get at that time. Then I can play all the games of this beast of a high-performance gaming machine, something I could have had in 1997. So for my final point in this video, I think that the biggest reasons why we still keep on using so much money, time and effort into this hobby is the community. Because, believe it or not, we are nerds, but we are still social animals. You can communicate with other like-minded people on Facebook, Twitter, Reddit, forums, YouTube. And they give you encouragement and support. And sometimes hate. But for the most part, people are cheering you on for repairing and saving yet another old computer. Or you just have pleasant conversations. Some really smart people are also developing new hardware for your old computers. It's amazing what people are able to do. They make new and improved sound cards, graphics cards, HDMI solutions, faster CPU replacements, modern controllers. There are just so many things being made for our old computers. It makes everything more convenient and easier, but it can also really enhance the old graphics and sound, so your old games looks and sounds so much better than before. So I hope this made it a bit more clear for why we spend so much time, money and effort on these old computers. But anyway, thank you for watching.